Coming up, Jonathan investigates a spooky cenote in Mexico filled with odd formations that look like bells. Are they biological or geological? Welcome to Jonathan Bird's Blue World.
The jungles of the Yucatan in Mexico are filled with incredible wonders. The limestone beneath the jungle is filled with caves. All the water in the Yucatan is underground. There are no surface rivers. It flows through these cave systems. In places, the ceiling of the cave has collapsed, producing formations called cenotes. These cenotes were sacred sources of water for the ancient Maya. But for us, they're also entrances to the cave systems below the jungle. There are all kinds of interesting things to see in these cenotes and caves, from speleothems like stalagmites and stalactites, to blind cavefish. Sometimes there are bones from animals and even humans. But a few cenotes hold something incredibly rare and not well understood. In Cenote Zapote, yes, that's the actual name, near Puerto Morelos, there are mysterious formations known as cave bells. To see these mysterious formations, cameraman Todd and I are heading down to the Yucatan for a cave diving adventure. We meet up with my good friend Christine Loew, an experienced local cave diving instructor and guide. She knows just about every cave and cenote in the area. We drive to Puerto Morelos to visit Zapote. Along the way, we make a stop at the Museo del Desierto, otherwise known as the Desert Museum in Saltillo, where Dr. Geronimo Aviles shows us some of the amazing discoveries that have come from local cenotes. He also gives us a little science lesson on the cave bell formations.
So the biggest one has 4 meters width and 4 meters long. So they're very, very big. I've measured the biggest one in Zapote Cenote, still hanging.
Yeah.
Because in the floor of Cenote Zapote, it's littered with this. So, but Zapote was the second place where we saw them. And those are the ones that we based the study on.
Now we're really excited to see them underwater. Todd, Christine, and I head way out into the jungle to reach Zapote. Zapote is located in a nature park. There's a platform above the cenote to jump in. But you have to look carefully first, because there are often divers down there. The rare formations make this a popular dive site.
Oh, you go the second level and then it's like 11 meters.
We have a walk down to the water to check it out. From the surface, it sure doesn't look like much. But the water seems very inviting on a hot day. There are some divers already in there.
We let them go in the water first,
yep.
And then we go down.
Stairs make diving very civilized.
Whew. That's my favorite part of this.
That is so wonderful.
I love that part. Carrying heavy stuff.
Can't forget the cameras. Finally, it's time to suit up. You have to be very careful not to drop anything while you do this, because the cenote is so deep, you will never get it back. Zapote is shaped like a bottle. It's small at the surface, but gets wider as we go deeper. The first thing we see is an ancient tree that fell in here thousands of years ago. In this low oxygen environment, the tree has not decomposed. Soon we find the cave bell formations, which look like sponges growing downward from an overhang. These are like nothing I've ever seen. And while they look like sponges, they definitely don't feel like them. They're as hard as stone, made of tiny crystals all growing on top of each other. In most caves, speleothem formations like stalagmites and stalactites were formed long ago during ice ages when sea levels were lower, so the water table was lower. At the time, the caves were not submerged, they were dry. The speleothems were formed by water dripping from above, leaving trace elements of calcite that formed icicle-looking structures of stone. But the bell formations have been thorium dated, and they've formed within the last 5,000 years, meaning the water level has not been low enough during this time for them to have formed in air. They're actually forming underwater. Scientists are not sure exactly how they form, but they're only found in 7 cenotes in the world, all of them within a few miles of Zapote. The current theory is that there's something special about the water chemistry in these 7 cenotes, and there might be a special bacteria involved in the process. But somehow, calcite crystallizes into these formations, which start as small nubs and then grow downward, getting wider as they grow, like bells. Since they're thought to be formed by a unique relationship with bacteria, they're often referred to as biothems rather than speleothems. Analysis of the growth patterns has shown that the formations grow only 1 millimeter every 10 years. But even growing that slowly, after about 4,000 years, they get so big and heavy, weighing hundreds of pounds, that they break under their own weight. They fall to the bottom of the cenote nearly 200 feet deep. As we wander around the entire circumference of the cenote, we can observe thousands of these formations. But they only grow in a narrow depth range of about 100 feet deep. It's possible that the water chemistry is only right to form the bells for a narrow range of depths. As we get a little deeper, the water gets cloudier. We're entering a toxic hydrogen sulfide layer, produced by decomposition of organic material that falls in from the forest above. The bells seem to form right at the edge of the hydrogen sulfide layer. Christine leads us into the center of the cenote to have a look at the tree. Carbon dating tells us that this tree is about 3,500 years old, but it's well preserved down here. And on one part of the tree, there are little bells forming. They start out as just tiny little nubs. The fact that they're forming on a tree of known age was the first clue that helped researchers understand that the bells form underwater. We spent a long time down at 100 feet, so now it's time to head up and do a decompression stop in the shallows before we can head to the surface. We spend some time looking at the plants thriving in the sunshine. And of course, hoping nobody jumps on us from the platform.
Was completely different than I expected. I thought the formations were going to be like spongy, but they're actually kind of like a crystal. Just so many of them. I couldn't believe it. I thought maybe there'd be like a few, but the whole place is just covered with them. Incredible.
And we can't leave without cameraman Todd taking the plunge from the platform. Zapote is an amazing place. Every time I think I've seen it all, I get to see something new that I had no idea even existed. The Cave Bell formations are super rare and so mysterious that scientists still don't even know exactly how they form. It's just another fascinating mystery of the blue world. Hey everyone! Thanks for watching our latest episode all the way to the end. Hit that subscribe button now so you won't miss our next episode. And check out our new second channel, Blue World Plus, for some awesome behind-the-scenes vlogs and extras.